Hey guys, LevelCap here. Today we're going to talk about the state of Battlefield 1. This is brought up by a dev post on Reddit asking for feedback on Battlefield 1. What we want to see changed, what we want to see improved or balanced. And there's been a ton of feedback so far. I encourage you guys to leave your own feedback on what you want to see changed or added to the game. I'll leave a link for that Reddit post in the video description. I'd like to begin the video by going over some of the most popular things said over on that Reddit post, and then I would also like to add some of my own there and sort of gauge your interest or where you stand on the line of what you think needs to be changed or what you would like to be changed for Battlefield 1. Some of the most popular stuff on there was spawning on dead players. It's been an issue since the beginning of Battlefield 1. This is where you kill somebody on the battlefield, you think you're clear, you gotta reload your weapon, and all of a sudden another player spawns there and guns you down while you're like mid-reload. I've seen this happen in what feels like 2 to 3 seconds after I've killed a player. It's pretty bad. DICE has been aware of the issue, and I assume they've been working on it this whole time, but hopefully they'll get it fixed one of these days. It's been long enough for such a serious bug. The second most popular topic I saw mentioned was the ADAD spam. This is basically being able to side strafe left and right to dodge incoming fire, or even fire while doing this to make yourself an incredibly hard to hit target. This has been an issue in Battlefield 3, Battlefield 4. DICE has made changes to try and fix it. It's more of an issue in Battlefield 1 because the time to kill is significantly longer, so players can stand there for quite a while doing their ADAD dance. And it becomes really annoying, it looks stupid, and I think DICE should try and slow this down by decreasing player acceleration properties. It can make your player feel a little bit more sluggish, but it'll result in more realistic player animations and less jerky movements. Anti-cheat system was another popular one up there. Although I can't say I've seen a lot of cheaters in Battlefield 1 recently, I do know it is something that exists right now, whether it's aimbots, wall hacks, whatever. I have a feeling there's probably a significant amount of players using wall hacks and just not aimbots, which is kind of frustrating. Fortunately or unfortunately, depending on your opinion here, Battlefield 1 is so spam-based and so chaotic, it can be quite difficult to determine if somebody is cheating unless they're just using blatant damage mods or aimbot hacks and like one-shotting you with a pistol across the map. It has happened to me before. It's not in a state where I think it's like dire right now, but I do know some players or different regions are probably affected by it a bit more than others. Another popular topic is the auto balancing. Yeah, there's a lot of one-sided games in Battlefield 1, whether it's Operations or Conquest, the games can feel pretty lopsided at times. This is a difficult situation because you've got a thing where clans will try and play together, you'll get a lot of top-ranked players working together and trying to achieve victory, and they will ultimately really sway things in one direction for their team. And that can be rough, especially when you're playing against a team of 32 randoms. These are 64-player games and balancing them is difficult. I always give DICE a bit of leeway on this because it's never been something that's been a strong point of any of the Battlefield games. Team balancing has always been a bit crazy, but hopefully they can try and incorporate a bit more team switching in between rounds and sort of base it instead of off of general player stats, how about their performance in the previous round and try and balance up the teams a bit more. I have no idea how it works right now. Maybe that is part of how it currently works, but trying to get the teams as balanced as possible is certainly a good idea. The next big topic was PC and console separate balancing. Now, a lot of high profile games like Overwatch incorporate different weapon mechanics, whether you're playing on PC or console. This is due to the fact that there can be a lot of sticky auto-aim, or just in general, aiming on controller is a different experience and you have to balance the weapons accordingly. It's unfortunate that this hasn't been taken on by the dev team earlier, as it's an important thing for any game trying to be a high-profile shooter. Other development teams have done this. Battlefield 1 should really get on board to refine the weapon balance mechanics. The next biggest community issue was Conquest scoring, and I assume, based on what I've seen so far, that this is referring to the fact that you can't come back from a big deficit in Conquest anymore. You used to be able to do this in Battlefield 3, Battlefield 4, Battlefield Hardline. They had a really fun comeback mechanic where a squad of players could join a Conquest server, see that they're losing, and really turn it around by holding the majority of flags for the rest of the game. This would stop ticket bleed for the losing team, and you could actually come back and win the game. Sometimes the rounds of Conquest would last pretty long because of this, but it was always fun and had an extremely rewarding feeling when you brought a team back from the brink. This doesn't happen anymore in Battlefield 1, and you can kind of tell halfway through a round who's going to win the game based on where it's going. It just isn't as fun of an experience anymore, and I think people really like those epic comebacks, and that's just not a part of Battlefield 1 Conquest anymore. I don't think I've seen any epic comebacks since I started playing this game, and I've got hundreds and hundreds of hours into it. So I would love to see a return to the classic ways of doing Conquest. I don't know why DICE decided to try and fix a system that wasn't broke in the first place, but here we are with new Conquest that just isn't as enjoyable. Another popular issue was the blackout or whiteout effects from trying to overcompensate for transitioning from a light environment to a dark environment or from a dark environment to a light environment. The Frostbite engine tries to exaggerate what your eyes do for you naturally in the game engine. It's really obnoxious because it creates a situation where you literally just won't be able to see your enemies because it's too dark, because the game engine's like, oh look, you're transitioning from one environment to another, I'm gonna make everything insanely dark and you can't see it. Strategically, you could argue maybe this has a cool effect and players could take advantage of it, but I think for 99% of the time it's just obnoxious and most players don't like it. Hopefully DICE can tone this down by about 50%. Now, an issue that's been 50% fixed, but the community hasn't forgotten about it, is the instant bayonet charge. That's where somebody can activate a bayonet charge from 1 foot away. So it's not really a charge, it's just an instantaneous melee takedown by exploiting a poorly designed mechanic. DICE did a decent job of nerfing some of the bayonet charge qualities already, but I think they could take it a bit further and just make it so that you cannot bayonet charge somebody from a few feet away. It shouldn't be that hard to write the code for it, and it would be a nice addition to the game and get rid of some of the bayonet charging exploits. Just some of the most annoying mechanics in the game, why not just get rid of them? Then I also saw multiple times better handling of transport vehicles. This is basically the situation where there's a lot of large maps in Battlefield 1 and just not enough transport vehicles to get into to get over there, or how they spawn in deployment or where they spawn walking towards transport vehicles, not knowing where people or vehicles are going to be. This is kind of an issue. It's something that wasn't an issue in Battlefield 3 or Battlefield 4 or Battlefield Hardline. Vehicles, or at least transit vehicles, would spawn on map. People could tell where they are, be like, okay, if we just go to point B first, we can grab that car and then drive over to point A, and that'll allow us to get there faster. Battlefield 1 doesn't really have that mechanic. It's harder to get around, it takes longer to get around, and I think they could definitely work on the transport vehicle system. Another issue that I think DICE would like to decide as a concluded topic is grenade spam. They reduced it. They made it way more tolerable than it used to be. It's not good though. I still get killed by random grenades all the time, and it's still a very effective technique to randomly throw grenades into an area because the detonation timer is short enough that a lot of people can't escape it in time or react to it strategically. Especially with classes like the Assault, who have anti-tank grenades and then normal grenades, or the support class with their grenade launcher crossbow, there's enough explosive spam in the game. You could take it a bit further and reduce the throw time and maybe even detonation timer further. There's more explosive spam in Battlefield 1 than I've seen in any other Battlefield game in recent memory, and that's with the inclusion of all the other crap in the game that goes boom. Why not tone down the grenades just a little bit so that the rest of it becomes slightly more tolerable? Now, those topics I just mentioned were the most popular ones on Reddit. I saw many people giving the same feedback. I agree with all those points there. They make a lot of sense, and they're important aspects of the game that should be worked on. I would also like to add some of my own personal issues that I think other people have had, but just weren't mentioned as much on Reddit. One of the top ones is the shooting range. I mean, it's been long enough. People need a shooting range to test out weapons. It makes a lot of sense for people to be able to try and determine what the different variations of weapons handle like. A shooting range would be a great environment for that. Also, allowing everyone to test out DLC weapons in the shooting range would be kind of cool, and it could work as sort of incentive for players to want to buy DLC or buy in a premium if they could try out the guns there first. Another thing that really irks me since launch is that the end of round score screen or the highlights or medal system never rewards players for being best in the game, having the highest score or the most kills. I understand that the game has taken a huge shift towards trying to promote teamwork and always promoting things like people who dropped the most ammo or got the most revives, but still, being a player who's kicking ass and killing tons of people, shutting down flanks, shouldn't be something that the game totally disregards, and it's always bugged me. Like, I finished, I think, 5 games the other day, top of the team, both in frags and points, and I never even once, I think once I showed up on the highlight list and it was for most flags defended. I just think it's kind of lame that DICE has shifted so far away from any form of killing being recognized as a valuable aspect of a player and just shifted it towards, hey, how many flags can you stand on or how many ammo and med crates can you throw down? Important aspects of the game, I'm not going to deny that. But also, guess what? Killing and shutting down flanks is pretty damn important too. So I think that should be rewarded better in the end of rounds highlight screen. Another thing that drives me absolutely crazy in Conquest and Operations games is vehicle spawn stealing. I don't know if this is like a latency issue or whatever, but I'll select a tank or an airplane, I'll look at the map and decide, you know what, I'm gonna need a different loadout for this vehicle before I spawn in. I go into my loadout screen, try and change the loadout of that tank or airplane, and somebody else manages to steal that vehicle from me from the spawn screen. Don't know why this happens, it's been happening since the beginning of the game. Drives me absolutely crazy. It doesn't, however, happen if I just double click on the spawn as fast as possible and spawn in with whatever vehicle I had pre-selected. This is a terrible way to try and spawn in with an airplane or tank, as you can't really anticipate what you might need for the round, and just trying to get the vehicle by spamming that spawn key as fast as possible is a terrible system. So hopefully DICE can fix this. Another thing that kind of goes hand in hand with some of the grenade spam is the gas grenade mechanics. Right now, the edge of the gas cloud is very hard to determine. You can easily walk into a gas cloud, taking damage or even dying from it, not realizing that it was there in the first place. Especially if you've taken any amount of damage and your screen turns red, it becomes almost impossible to see the edge of a gas cloud. I think this mechanic needs to be addressed, in addition to making it so that gas can't travel through floorboards of buildings or even solid walls where there's no area for the gas to pass through. It gets really annoying when you're constantly taking damage through walls and floors. Now, something that somebody else brought up on Reddit a while ago, which I wholeheartedly agree with, is the fact that there's no standard or official DICE servers that actually rotate through the vanilla maps and then also the DLC maps. This makes some of the premium users out there have far less value in their actual servers. It would be really cool to have a server that you could vote between different premium maps or different vanilla maps. This would give you so much more variety in general as a premium player, and that's part of the benefits of being a premium player is variety, weapon variety, map variety. Not being able to take advantage of that in a single server really sucks. When it comes to gameplay balance, Operations without question needs another pass-through. There's just some maps that don't play well or have easily exploitable points. The bunker in Monte Grappa is still a problem. I don't know why DICE hasn't fixed this. All you gotta do is change the capture point so it doesn't exist within the bunker. And there you go. You could even take it a step further and like add some destruction to the rooftop of the bunker and make it so that players could destroy that and then drop in from above or drop explosives down from above, allowing them to cap the point. Right now, how it plays out on Monte Grappa is that an overwhelming force that has clearly dominated an area cannot get into some of those bunkers, regardless of how many players or how much skill they have. And it's just a problem. It's game breaking. Also, I would say that the first set of objectives in Ballroom Blitz is a problem, especially for when the attacking team gets the behemoth right away. There's no way to take it down, so you just basically have to die to it all round until you fall back to the next set of points. I think this could both be remedied by adding in behemoth defense, to the first set of objectives, but also maybe making it so that the attacking team has some better vehicles, as I found it to be a little bit too easy to defend those first set of objectives. Now, the points I've mentioned so far are things that I think DICE might actually change or the community might agree upon. I've got plenty of other things, but I just don't think DICE is really going to take a swing at them based on what their stance has been so far. I would love to see suppression reduced or removed completely. There's plenty of videos of snipers hitting shots that they clearly missed because they are actually suppressed in the first place. It's just a dumb mechanic to have in any game, but I think Battlefielders have been fighting the suppression fight since Battlefield 3, and DICE has basically said, nah, we're going to keep it in the game. So I would love to see that removed, but I don't expect to see it go anywhere. I'd also love to see a deep dive into weapon mechanics and weapon balance. There's just some guns that are clearly superior than other weapons in Battlefield 1. The Automatico was just unrivaled in close quarter combat by far compared to anything else, where you take a look at like Battlefield 4 or Battlefield 3 and you got weapons that could be considered the best, but the second tier right below them is only like 5% worse, or just barely, you know, in terms of time to kill, and they have other benefits. Battlefield 1, it's a huge stretch between some of the top tier weapons and the guns right below them. Also, the random deviation mechanics are just mind-numbingly painful, especially with guns like the Medics 1907. That gun just gets obnoxious to use because of the deviation. Infantry versus air is still in a state that sucks. I mean, BF3, BF4, Battlefield Hardline, even Bad Company 2, they all had weapons that could fight aircraft if they needed to. Sure, it was always better to have your own airplanes up in the air, but if you had enough dedicated players on the ground, they could take out the aircraft with some of the rocket launchers or other cool weapons at their disposal. Now you basically are solely reliant on anti-aircraft guns and maybe getting a lucky sniper headshot on one of the pilots, which you could again do in previous Battlefield games. So I just think the balance between infantry and air isn't particularly good right now. I'd love to see a buff in terms of how much damage infantry could do against aircraft, and maybe to compensate for that, a slight nerf for AA guns or something like that. Especially playing the new Lupkow Pass DLC map, where there's one plane on either side and very limited anti-aircraft guns, the infantry are basically helpless against the airplanes, and it just kind of sucks playing against them. I would love to see sort of a balance where a good infantry player has a higher chance of taking out an airplane on a flyby. I'd also like to see airburst mortars pretty much removed from the game. Let support use the high explosive mortars and become more of an anti-vehicle class. God knows we need more help trying to take out good tank drivers, or tank drivers that are willing to exploit how easy it is to use some of the tank classes in the game. Making support slightly more effective against vehicles, or forcing them to use more anti-armor weapons, I think would be a good shift. The airburst mechanic in the game, it's just crazy annoying. It's stupid when you're trying to push up with teammates and getting constantly hammered by them, or falling back to cover only to get hammered by more airburst mortars. It's just my personal opinion. I think there's too much explosive spam in the game, and airburst mortars are one of the prime problems with that. Anyway, that kind of wraps it up for this list of changes that first the community would like to see, and then some of my own personal changes that I would like to see made to the game. Battlefield 1 is a fun game. I'm enjoying it now, but I don't play it anywhere near as much as I used to play Battlefield. And a large part of that is due to many of the issues I have listed here today. There's been some cool improvements with Battlefield 1 over previous Battlefield games, but a lot of downgrades that came with it as well. And I think DICE could really spend a lot of time trying to refine this game before pushing the next one out the door, as I think they have a lot of lessons to learn with how to make Battlefield a great game again. Anyway, let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. Don't forget to add your feedback to the Reddit post if you're interested in doing that. And I'll see you next time. This is Level Cap, signing off.